بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In this video, I just wanted to address some of the most common questions that I get asked in regards to my conversion to Islam. Of course, the most common question is typically, why or how did you embrace Islam? I think the answer to that question is worthy of a video in and of itself, so I don't want to really get into that. But long story short, I read the Quran and I believe that it was from God. I believe that it was a miracle and that only the Creator could have revealed such a scripture to mankind. That's why I embraced Islam. After that, I'm typically always asked the following question. How did your parents react? Well, since I embraced Islam just after reading the Quran, I obviously didn't know everything about the religion. I didn't know all the customs, everything that was permissible or forbidden. I just knew that I believed that the Quran was from God. So it was still an uneasy feeling because, you know, we didn't really know what to expect. Okay, now you're a Muslim. What does this mean? How are you going to act? How are you going to change? At first, it was really just a matter of me wanting other people to read the Quran with the expectation that they would see in it what I saw in it. So initially my parents included, but just everyone around me in general, I would try to give them the Quran thinking, okay, to me, this is obviously from God. So read this, you're going to see the same thing. But nobody I gave the Quran to just embraced Islam like that. So that was something I had to cope with, and I had to stop trying to debate people and argue with them and get frustrated about them not becoming Muslim. So that was sort of the first obstacle I faced, and it created somewhat of an uneasy environment with my parents. But as time went on and I traveled to different Muslim communities and I met other Muslims, particularly my elders, you know, the older Muslims in the different masajid, they would of course ask me, how did you become Muslim and how did your parents react? And I would tell them, and they would always emphasize, in America they emphasize this, and even here in Saudi, when I would talk to the administration at Medina University, they would always say, you have to be good to your parents. You need to treat them with the best of manners, and your parents have so many rights over you, and you need to treat them with the most beautiful of treatment. So in America, I think I went to Virginia for a weekend and I stayed at a masjid, and I was told this again by some of the elders there. And when I came back home, you know, I sat my parents down and I apologized to them and I said, you know, I'm really sorry. And I told them how sorry I was for being harsh with them, and that this isn't proper Islamic etiquette, and that, you know, I love them and I hope that they'll forgive me. And after that, I just tried to live up to that in terms of treating them with the best of manners. So after that, you know, my relationship with my parents was better than ever, you know, especially in regards to my adult life. Also, it's important to point out that, you know, this says a lot about my parents, about how loving and open-minded and respectful they are, because there are a lot of people who embrace Islam. I've heard many stories that their parents, they don't take it well. Some people, they get kicked out of their house and they're on very bad terms with their family. But alhamdulillah, you know, my family, they've always raised me in a way to be respectful of people and understanding of different ideologies, different cultures, and so on and so forth. So aside from, you know, the first maybe month or couple months of me becoming Muslim, after that things have been better than ever, and it extends beyond just my mother and father. I mean, also my sister, my grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins. Like, because Islam really emphasizes maintaining family ties, I began to try to implement that in my life, and I began building very strong bonds with certain members of my family, whereas prior to Islam, it wasn't really a concern of mine, but Islam inspired me to do that. So, you know, even if we have different ideologies and differences in the way that we live and the things that we believe, just showing different members of my family how much they mean to me and that I care about them and I want to maintain strong ties with them, it has created a very warm family environment. It's not perfect. There are certain struggles that a Muslim is going to face when they're around non-Muslims, just because beliefs and customs are different and misunderstood. But for the most part, as long as the love and the respect is there. Muslims and non-Muslims within, you know, a single household or family can still have a very loving and strong relationship, inshallah. Another question is, how did your friends react? This was somewhat similar because also when I became Muslim, I sort of, just like I expected members of my family to read the Quran and believe it was from God and become Muslims, I sort of approached my friends in the same way, I guess. So, of course, I mean, people, they don't like being preached to. They don't like being told what to believe or what to think. And I was still struggling with the idea that, to me, this is the truth, and to other people, they're not seeing what I see in it. So it took some time, I guess, to develop the proper manners and the proper etiquette in terms of interacting with non-Muslims, both family and friends. But I think at this point I've established a pretty good balance. I mean, when it comes to friends, and this is something that a lot of parents tell their children when they're young, they always emphasize how important family is, you know, because sometimes when we're young, we'll give preference to our friends over our family. We might just feel like we have more in common at certain points in our life with our friends, and we'll get along with them and have fun with them, and we might think that our family can't relate, or they're not, we don't see eye to eye as much, or we don't enjoy each other's company as much. But the fact of the matter is, as you grow, I mean, just think about, all of us can think about how many friends have come and gone. If we're fortunate enough, we do have some childhood friends that we've kept in close contact with for many, many years. But for the most part, friends come and go for various reasons. It's not always malicious, but sometimes people, they grow and they change. And your family, you guys are bound by blood. There's something inside of you that will always cause you to be attached to them. But friends, I mean, sometimes they come and go, and you don't talk to them as much, you don't see them as much, you don't have as much in common as you grow older. So for example, when I was young, I was heavily into music, and I had a lot of friends who shared that common interest with me. So at any given time during the weekend, I might have between 5-10 friends over at my house, and we would be maybe working on music. But then, you know, I became Muslim, I gave up music, and 90% of them sort of, you know, disappeared. And that's not to say that they were wrong for disappearing, it's just we didn't really have that much in common anymore. And when you change your life, you become a different person with different interests. Now that's not part of my life. Okay, well, how do we adapt? What do we have in common now? And sometimes there's not a whole lot there, you know, other than just past memories. Alhamdulillah, I'd say for the most part, all of my friends, we'll touch base, we'll keep in touch. Some obviously more than others, but you know, relationships change. And I think this is also just natural in regards to anybody getting older. I mean, I think most people who, when they get older, they become more family oriented, usually get married, have kids, and get a full-time job. They don't have time to really hang out with their friends like they did when they were younger and in school and things like that. At the same time, you know, I made lots of new friends. You know, alhamdulillah, I made lots of friends who share the same interests as me in regards to Islam. So the transition, it wasn't so difficult, because with every friend that I lost, I had a friend that I made. And there wasn't really any bridges that were burned. So I guess that answers that question.